plug, my other guy sucks. Ready, got a buzz, out 25 bucks. Drop 200, I got too much, and I got too fried, I'm sunny side up. Got your dad, don't blow off my ass. Got your mom trying to suck on my nuts. Don't tell me money don't buy happiness when it so happen that money buy drugs. Therefore, by the transit of property, when I'm fucked up, don't talk to me. I feel like it's a bunch of little bugs on top of me. Help me, I can't get them off of me. I can't move, I'm stuck in a sofa. They're stuck in a room where the walls get closer. Next time you try fucking me over, I'll put you in the back with a plug being toaster. It's too late, no one can stop me. Hey Siri, how do you get rid of a body? Chop it up, do a little bit of karate. I'm doing 90 and it's sitting in a bag riding shoddy. Such a good boy when I was 18, but I smoked alcohol and drank weed, and now my brain turned into baked beans. Don't be like me, kids, I'm fried. Got a new plug, my other guy sucks. Ready, got a buzz, out 25 bucks. Drop 200, I got too much, and I got too fried, I'm sunny side up. Got your dad, don't blow off my ass. Got your mom trying to suck on my nuts. Don't tell me money don't buy happiness when it so happen that money buy drugs. I feel obligated to say this, kids don't do drugs. Drugs are dangerous, the brain can change in ways I can't explain, but it feel like I'm stuck in a simulation. Too sad it is for the euthanasia. The voice in my head got too persuasive, the flu contagious. Everybody dead except a couple rich white dudes in space. Ding ding, time is up. The world is ending, the climate sucks. I'm high and drunk, driving a cyber truck. The AI talking to me like it's trying to fuck.
Fuck me.
Such a good boy when I was 18, but I smoked alcohol and drank weed, and now my brain turned into baked beans. Don't be like me, kids, I'm fried. Got a new plug, my other guy sucks. Ready, got a buzz, out 25 bucks. Drop 200, I got too much, and I got too fried, I'm sunny side up. Got your dad, don't blow off my ass. Got your mom trying to suck on my nuts. Don't tell me money don't buy happiness when it so happen that money bites.
And hello, everybody. Welcome once again to the Devil's Hour. My name is Jeff with the G, and for the next, hour or so, we'll be showcasing the weird, the wild, and the wonderful, all for you. How's everybody doing? Doing good? I'm doing all right. Pardon me. I've had several shows this week, not performing, but in them, and sort of shooting and hollering, so my voice sounds a little off. That's why. Taping this on Easter Sunday, for those that follow it, for those that don't. Sunday. It's a rare Sunday I have off, so it's kind of nice. We're just gonna get to it. Fox News. Alright, so Elon Musk, you know, everyone's favorite conflict diamond / tech union hater guy. If those things are true. He actually tried to buy Twitter this past week for a reported $43 billion. That's right, $43 billion. Via, buying up shares, people go, kind of go for like a hostile takeover. Of course, Twitter went, we're not going to do that. No, that's not cool. In fact, to help resist against this hostile takeover, they have adopted what they like to call the poison pill strategy. Now, before you guys think of poison pill strategy, what's that? Is that some weird kind of James Bondy, like sneak in the night, dropping poison in a sleeping mouth sort of thing? No, not nearly as exciting as that. Really, what that's about is Twitter is releasing shares at discounted prices to other to people with the hopes of just flooding the market with shares, so that way if Mr. Musk wants to buy up all the shares, it's not very financially feasible for one to do so. It just makes it more difficult, especially because he promised, I think, what, $54 a share or something like that. So he made that promise. So going from, like, I don't know, a couple of 43, so that changes how much money he's willing to spend, and he may or may not want to do that. I don't know. So Musk has stated that if he can't take over Twitter, make it his own little private, like, Infinity Stone in his gauntlet of stuff, he might just have to sell his shares. No worry what Doge thinks about this. Dumb jokes. So in Livonia, Michigan, right there at this little Grand River Academy school, a group of kindergartners were given a bit more than just juice at snack time. Yeah, seems that one of the kids had brought a 4-pack of Jose Cuervo margarita, premix margarita stuff, and then took Dixie cups, poured it in Dixie cups, and had his own little played his own little young yeah, played. Sorry, I'm not gonna phrase this right. So this young guy made drinks and he poured it in Dixie cups and then played host to the youngest swinger party ever known. Talking about swings, man, don't be thinking so dirty with that. I don't know, I just thought of that dumb joke. I thought it was funny, but that really did happen. The kids got like sick and stuff like that, got crazy. That swinger party, just dumb joke. That's for me. Finally, a California-based finance company, the Monterey Financial Services, has agreed to pay more than $900,000 to settle allegations that it was illegally leasing dogs in Massachusetts. Yeah, not a euphemism. People were apparently leasing dogs because, like you can lease a car, have it for a while and then give it up or pay more to own it. Yeah. Now, if as long as you make the payments, it's cool. But if you don't, you might get a little doggy repossession. Yeah. That's like, say, if you miss that payment. I would say that the company has gone to the dogs, but anyway, there's also this.
Audible.com presents 50 Shades of Grey, the erotic best-selling novel read by Gilbert Gottfried.
My inner goddess has stopped dancing and is staring too, open-mouthed and drooling slightly.
Hear it the way it was meant to be heard.
Keep still, he orders, and slowly he inserts his thumb inside me, rotating it around and around, stroking the front wall of my vagina. No fisting, you say. Anything else you object to? I agree to the fisting, but I'd really like to claim your ass!
Famed voice actor Gilbert Gottfried gives a reading that can only be described as sensual.
Holy fuck, is this wrong! But holy hell, is it erotic!
Let Christian Grey seduce you over and over again. Through the voice of Gilbert Gottfried.
But when he hits my clitoris, I cry out loudly. Oh, please, I groan. Quiet, he orders. Not taking his eyes off mine, he scrunches my panties in his hand, holds them up to his nose, and inhales deeply. His hands reach around and touch my breasts, and my nipples pucker at his touch.
Holy shit, this is hot.
You're welcome, everybody. And rest in power, Gilbert Gottfried. I always find you funny. So we got a great show today. We've got Gore Gloss, we've got Desiree Desaad, we've got The Suffers, and all sorts of other weird fun shenanigans. So stay tuned and we'll be right back. Alrighty, how's everybody doing? We doing okay? Good. I'm glad. Let's talk about our first guest, shall we? So your first guest, all the way from Canada, Gorgloss, is kind of like a weird, kind of fun throwback to like 80s synth pop with these soothing, fantastically deep vocals, big rich bass, and a bright melody. They actually make me think of a lot of those kind of fun, like 8 synth pop tunes from the 80s, which were very kind of beautiful yet very cynical at the same time. I really dig it. You can definitely hear it on their first of this single right here, which is called Famous. So yeah, check them out. And I believe the lead singer's name is actually a G Jeff. So of course I gotta support the fuck out of that. So Gorgloss, everybody.
Famous. Ricky, it's your line. What the fuck are you talking? It's your line. You're supposed to ask me how the fucking tacos were.
I thought you said that.
No, you just...
Oh, hey, man. How the fuck were those, tacos last night?
Actually, you know what? The tacos were pretty good, but, you know, they weren't hot enough.
Weren't hot enough? Oh, you need green bastard hot sauce for your tacos and all your food. Oh, yeah!
You've got your own fucking hot sauce?
Bob, two pops. Green bastard, parts unknown.
It's nice, Bubs.
Give it a try, Ricky.
Holy fuck, man, that's good.
Oh, yeah!
You should be selling this shit. We should do a commercial for this. Not for tacos.
Holy fuck, Ricky.
We are doing a commercial for this,
it's fucking
Ricky.
Good.
Green bastard hot sauce. It'll fucking crank you one. Oh, yeah!
Gorgloss, everybody. Wasn't that a lot of fun? I thought so. I really dig that sound a lot, so definitely check it out. Also, make sure you pick up some Green Bastard Hot Sauce. It's delicious. If you're in the Coney Island area, you can actually go pick it up in the Coney Island gift shop at the Freak Bar, Coney Island, USA, where they've started doing their shows. It's pretty dope. Cast is amazing. It's a lot of fun. Really funny, somebody asked me if I'm on the cast this year, and I said no. And they go, why not? I go, because I like to fucking cuss. No, it just is how it works out. Doesn't matter. I'm still going to support it regardless. It's so cool. Anyways, as you guys know, I love showcasing the weird, the wild, and the wonderful, and that includes short films. And the things I like showcasing the most are the things from 48-hour film festivals, because those things don't get enough play, and there's some really amazing things out there. You never know, we might be seeing a future major cinephile or actor coming from all that sort of stuff, so you never know. Anyways, so check this out.
Yes, she told me all about it. And in English, so I expect you all to do the same.
Actually, that's the author's name.
I'm sure it is. My name is Sergeant Sally Hall, but since I'm off duty today, you guys can call me Sergeant. Jane has asked me to come in to find out who's been bringing illicit materials to your weekly meetings to kick them out.
Oh, Jane! If you didn't want to read the DeBoomer stuff at meetings anymore, you didn't need to bring a cop! We could just kick two out!
Hey!
There's two of them?
Oh, she's talking about me. I'm too... too bad. Gave myself that name. My mom makes me come to these meetings. That's fine, but I'm not gonna use the name she gave me.
Okay, it's obviously him.
All right, guys. Easy money on the guy who calls himself Too Bad, bringing hentai to the Hentai Addicts Anonymous meeting. But that is a decision based on stereotypes. And a good detective knows to never make a decision based on stereotypes.
But I am gonna start with him.
What? How did you build this so fast?
Let's start with how you got here.
Sure. Dumb mom's picking up my room and stumbles across my Sora Imo Hime-sama and freaks out.
I need to get my translator app out for this one.
It's like the original mag, you know? It defined the genre.
Pretty sure it has Japanese.
Of course it is. If it isn't Japanese, it's not the right thing.
So anyways, you can imagine mom gets pretty upset and decides to start making me go to these things.
No, that's not it. Damn it.
Yeah, I was pretty pissed at first, but I managed to push her into a deal.
How do you go back?
No, not back. Forward. See, if I do this program for 3 months, then she will finally buy me a ticket to Japan.
All right, think I got it.
Only 6 more weeks till real life in Suliana.
Briny Crevice.
Point is, I'm not your guy. Too much on the line to mess it up now.
You should know I'm only in this for the art, okay? I mean, some people think that they're getting major character development from what? Four Avengers movies? No, there are some manga storylines that have been around for over 25 years, okay? The most honest, ambitious, and enlightening art of the past decade is right in the pages of the Cuboid Cupido.
Suction cup, sweetheart.
So why come to these meetings?
I just... it was too good. I lost myself. Okay? I don't read this stuff. I'm a collector. These things sell crazy fast online. I started with a few Shida Kajira that I found at a flea market.
Beneath the whale.
Made $300. So I go back and I find a few old cover Sonojo Kajiras.
Above the whale.
Another $300. Then $1,200 for a 1 in 300 variant Sonojo Kajira.
Inside.
But then the flea market dried up.
Imagine. Not a lot of places left for the whale to go.
You don't get it, okay? The mags that show up at these meetings aren't available anywhere else. Everybody loves them, and I'm gonna be the only person on this planet to sell Dubaru Haitai Surus.
Double negative.
All right. Big reveal time. Unfortunately, the twist is almost as bad as Too Bad's Japanese. Not only did Too Bad bring the comics, he wrote them!
Well, prove it!
Dorobu Haitsu, the author of this book, translates to double negative. A poor attempt at writing Too Bad.
Shit!
Wow! In fact, the double negative has led to proof positive!
Yes, he did it. He's the one. But the good news is, Ruby can help you learn how to sell your stuff.
I don't know. Kinda over it all now.
Of course you are. Jane, what are you doing here?
Oh. To be completely honest, the hentai gave me an unrealistic expectation. Like, yes, I know a squid can't love me. And I know that there's no deep sea kingdom full of jellyfish waiting to make me their vertebrae queen, but do I know that? Do any of us truly know that?
Well, I'm glad I was here.
Boobdini here. Are you bored in the house and in the house bored? Well, we have the answer for you. It's the brand new burlesque deck. It will help you play with yourself while you're home alone.
Solitaire has never been this sexy. Ooh, Miss Orchid May goes right on top of Simone Del Mar.
Bored playing with yourself? Play with others.
Zoom has never been this much fun.
2, 3, 4! War! Ooh, I have a... Now, just slightly by Simone Del Mar! Yay! Hanky-panky! Not only do you get these 52 amazing playing cards, but we've included this, a cheat sheet of who the 26 performers are. Buy yourself a deck today. Cure the boredom at burlesquedeck.com.
How's everybody doing? Doing good? Fun flick, right? Kind of learned a little bit about some stuff, huh? Good for you. No king shame. In fact, I'd like the idea of somebody coming up to me later going, hey, I watched a thing in your show, and not going to lie, kind of dug it. Hasn't happened yet, but yeah, well, you know, dreams can be made. Anyways, let's talk about our next guest, shall we? Dubbed a professional weirdo, and if anybody knows about weirdos, this guy. Desiree Desaad has been bringing her love of the strange and unusual to burlesque stages in New York City since January 2018. Like the historical cabinet of curiosities, you never know what nonsense or oddity Desiree will pull out next. And as a master of transformation, even her own friends don't always recognize her from act to act. I mean, really, that's actually kind of true. I've had a chance to see her many times. Each act has been distinctly different from the last one in a most glorious sort of way. So much so that, like, you think about it, it's that idea of, like, you know, where it's scary meets sexy meets what the fuck? It's very, very true. So Desiree is pretty dope. Really good friend of mine. I've actually had her do a live Devil's Hour here in New York, and we've hung out and done stuff. I think we're talking about this stuff later. I don't know. We'll find out. Anyways, I had a chance to actually see this act I'm about to showcase to you guys live, and holy fuck. Anyways, let's give it up for the one, the only, the amazing Desiree Desaad, everybody.
She is known as the Cabinet of Burlesque Curiosities. Please welcome to the stage, Desiree Desaad.
Yeah. You guys already decided, everybody. Wasn't that dope? Crazy. Yeah. I saw that show live. Fuck, right? Anyways. Yeah, time it is for, right? Alright, so today I want to talk about picture to get a little bigger, because this is how professional I am. There we go. A little nicer, so you can see the pictures better. So today I want to talk about Joe Greenstein, a.k.a. the Mighty Atom. See, Joe was, or Joseph, was born in 1893 in Poland. As a child, he actually suffered from respiratory ailments. I couldn't breathe well, and doctors believed he wouldn't live long. But he actually persevered, and why he persevered is he found comfort in doing these strongman regimens they learned from a famed Russian strongman who was by the name of Champion Volanko. And so that's what he did. And then when he became an adult, Joe ended up becoming a wrestler. Yeah, a wrestler. Now, that time period wrestlers is a lot different than what it is today. Very much a true athletic act and things like that. So interesting. But due to the rising anti-Semitism in Eastern Europe where he was living at, because don't forget this is the 1910s, so shit was weird then. He and his wife actually made their way to the United States. Actually, originally, specifically, Galveston, Texas. Yeah. And there, he actually worked on the docks and in oil fields and stuff like that. But he still wrestled, and he wrestled by the name of, as known as, Kid Greenstein. Yeah, it's all true. But things changed a bit in 1914. You see, in 1914, a friend, I'm hoping a true friend, not a friend in quotation marks, accidentally shot him in the head. Shot him in the head. Weirdly, though, the bullet did not pierce his skull, but it did flatten it a bit. Yeah. The whole experience sparked Greenstein's interest in the mental powers concerning strength and whatnot, you know. So he actually went back to his strongman training and developed an array of strongman feats. There's another fun picture of him when he was young. He actually has been featured 5 times in Ripley's Believe It or Not. He has held multiple Guinness Book records. Unfortunately, all of those announcements have been beaten because it's about 1910s and 20s. It's probably his 2 most widely known acts were things like horseshoe bending and biting through the iron nail. Yeah, he did both of these things. Crazy. Now, later in life, as he got older in his like 40s and 50s, he actually took to selling health elixirs and coconut oil at fairs and at farmers markets. Yeah. He had 10 children, along with many more grandchildren. What's interesting is, in fact, his last public performance was at the age of 84 for his great-grandchild's birthday at Madison Square Garden, and this happened in 1977. And he... still at 84, he was still bending horseshoes and biting nails. And he actually even drove a nail through wood with his bare palm. Now, unfortunately, a few months later, he actually passed away from cancer. Yeah, so Mighty Atom, everybody. But here's a fun little addenda about that.
Oh, hello. Mighty Atom, Jr.
Hi.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
You're 93?
December was my 93rd birthday.
You pulled a car last time with your teeth.
It was approximately 3,500
pounds.
This time I'm pulling a truck close to 5,000 pounds.
1,500 more pounds than you pulled last time.
I was hoping the four of you would be in the back of the truck to add a little weight, and I'd love to do it.
Oh, my goodness. There you go.
Who's in the car? Who's in the driver's?
My kid brother.
Would you consider this, what he's doing, a feat of strength?
Oh, absolutely. But it's not one I would want to do.
He's 93. Oh. Are we ready?
Oh.
okay?
Are you okay?
Oh my God, we're moving. Oh my gosh. This is amazing. This is amazing.
93 years old.
And you're on the line.
Are you okay?
Yeah, he's on the line. Oh. You're okay?
I'm fine.
You feel good?
I feel good.
Oh my God. Well, thank you very much, okay? Go rest up.
Thank you.
93 years old and did that. This was a few years ago, because, you know, you see Howard Stern still in the cast, but still, the fuck. Yeah, the Mighty Atom and the Atom family, everybody. Dope, right? We'll be right back.
Is your bar looking a little ordinary?
Is it lacking something awesome?
Well, head out to your local liquor store and pick up something extraordinary. Grab a bottle of Old Humble Straight Whiskey or Old Humble Special Reserve. They're clean, smooth, easy drinking whiskeys that taste the way whiskey should taste. From humble beginnings to an extraordinary finish, Old Humble whiskeys are what your bar needs today. Walk tall, be awesome, and drink humble. Old Humble Straight Whiskey and Old Humble Special Reserve. Get yours today.
Yeah. How's everybody doing? We doing okay? Good. Well, this is the part of the show where I usually talk about older acts that I had back when I was doing this channel on Twitch, which I'm going to do today. And the next person I want to talk about, bring stuff up about, I wrote some stuff, so I'm just going to fly off the cuff. Because they're a really great performer. Who I'm going to talk about, person I want to talk about from shows past is Sylvia Salamanca. Now, Sylvia Salamanca is this amazing performer out of Houston, Texas. She's from originally from Spain, but lives in Houston with her now husband, Joshua Johnson, who's an amazing musician. Anyway, back to Sylvia. Sylvia is this award-winning belly dance performer. She actually went to school in Spain for like modern dance and ballet, and so she incorporated. Then, you know, later in life, she fell in love with belly dance, so she kind of incorporates all that together and creates these really amazing routines, right, and stuff like that. I mean, she'll never say this, but I've been told that she ranks as one of the best belly dancers in the world. So it's really dope. She's a really, really nice lady. I've had great conversations with her. Let's check out this really cool click that I have of her performances from a few years ago. So Sylvia Salamanca, everybody.
Thank you.
Sylvia Salamanca, everybody. Wasn't that dope? It's crazy. It's amazing. She's an amazing performer. Can't wait to see her sometime down the road. You doing okay today? So far, so good. Yeah, cool. All right, let's talk about our next guest, shall we? Next performers are the award-winning Houston band, The Suffers. They've been around together since about 2011, and they've really kind of staked what is known to be as like Gulf Coast soul sound, which is really good. And they actually make a point when they tour to say that they are a Houston band. They're very proud of the fact that they're from Houston, Texas. And they even made a point to saying that because they were actually, believe it or not, if you go back, the final week of The Late Show with David Letterman, they actually appeared on there. And it was like a weird random happenstance that all happened. It just happened like their stage manager went to a show down the street a day or so earlier, caught them live, went, no, this band needs to be part of the show. And they got to be part of it, which is pretty dope. They actually have a brand new album coming out really soon called It Starts With Love. June 3rd is when their album drops, so make sure you pick it up on your favorite download site, or go buy a physical copy, because you need one to support this band. They have a lead single for the singles, which is called Don't Bother Me, which is really dope. In fact, so dope, I want you to see it. So here we go, The Suffers, Don't Bother Me. Here we go.
Pass the water. Vaudevisuals Press is proud to announce the publication of Don't Miss This. Over 200 stunning photographs document the last decade of eccentric performing arts in America. This beautiful hardcover book features the finest theatrical clowns, sideshow performers, burlesque stars, and alternative variety acts from New York City and beyond. Photography by Jim R. Moore. Don't Miss This is a limited edition, so buy now before it disappears. Purchase at vvpress.com.
Suffers, everybody. Wasn't that amazing? So good. I really dig that band so much. I met the lead singer a few years ago at an open mic thing in Houston, and we just had a great time chatting. And such an amazing voice, amazing everything. So definitely pick up their record. Definitely well worth it. Did you guys have a good time today? I hope so. I had a great time. Thank you guys so much for tuning in and everything like that. We'll give some big thanks, everybody. I think we should. It's worthwhile. First off, let's thank Gore Gloss. You can follow them on Instagram at gore_gloss. I can talk, really. I can. Also, go to goregloss.bandcamp.com, pick up the record and stuff like that, and then download Famous on your favorite download music site. In addition, let's thank Desiree Desaad. Follow them on Instagram at Desiree Desaad, Desiree.D.Todd, pardon me, or go to their website, www.DesireeDesaad.com. Check out all the burlesque stuff. She's also a great photographer as well, so definitely check that shit out too. Last but finally not least, let's thank The Suffers, which you can follow on Instagram at The Suffers, and then go to www.thesuffers.com to keep track of all their stuff going on, including probably the site to, pick up that new record, because it's going to be worthwhile. Dope. Let's also give a retro thanks to Sylvia Salamanca, which you can follow on Instagram at salamanca.sylvia to keep track of everything she's going on. And last but not least, let's thank you guys for tuning in every week. Make sure you like and subscribe if you have not done so already, which you should, because I keep showcasing weird and wild crazy shit on here on the Carney Show Network, including there's all sorts of fun stuff as I've linked up to now with the Gaffing the Truth stuff from the Gaffing the Truth page, because that's also me too, kind of. I created that was a separate entity, but there's a playlist here on the channel which will get you right to that sort of stuff and catch the 40-some-odd episodes of me and Scab the Clown talking about the weird shit in the world, like UFOs and cults and whatnot. So definitely check that out too. Thank you guys once again for tuning in. I greatly appreciate it. So be safe, be cool, be groovy, and as always, keep drinking.